Our programs offer many languages. Please visit suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Nos programmes offrent plusieurs langues. Veuillez visiter suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Nuestros programas ofrecen varios idiomas. Visiten suprememastertv.com/schedule.
برنامه های ما شامل زبان های بسیاری است. از این وبسایت دیدن فرمایید suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Plastic is a great material, but right now it's against us simply because of irresponsible usage. This is our planet, this is our time on this planet. Let's do the right things. Let future generations look at us as a responsible generation of people.
Plastic pollution, its consequences for rivers and oceans. Part 3 of 3. Continue watching to find out more.
Zdravo means hello in Croatian. I'm Leona. The people of Croatia thank you for your efforts to remain cheerful despite any outer circumstances. May you be blessed abundantly for your joyful, positive attitude.
Welcome to the concluding episode of Plastic Pollution, Its Consequences for Rivers and Oceans. In part one of our series, we learned that plastic pollution in rivers, lakes, and oceans is so widespread that the United Nations has declared it a planetary crisis. In part two, we learned about the plastic pollution in the waters of Africa's Nile River, where more than 75% of the fish contain significant amounts of microplastics. In addition, plastic pollution is so pervasive along the banks of the Nile that domestic animals are inadvertently ingesting it. A veterinarian in Ethiopia conducted surgery on a one-year-old calf who had fallen ill. Inside the calf's stomach were several plastic bags and a plastic hairband. What can we do about this immense problem? On today's program, we'll look at some of the solutions emerging all around the globe. According to a 2019 study published in the journal Science Progress, as many as 90% of all plastic items are used only once and then discarded. Plastic bags are among the biggest sources of pollution, with as many as 5 trillion being consumed globally each year. When disposed of improperly, the bags clog waterways, pollute oceans, and choke marine life. Many nations have decided that this must stop. As of 2020, more than 90 countries have banned the use of single-use plastic bags, and an additional 36 nations minimize the problem by applying fees for their use. With its progressive legislation, France is a world leader in this regard. In 2015, the country banned plastic bags. Then in 2016, France became the first nation in the world to outlaw plastic cups, plates, and cutlery. In 2020, the country will also ban plastic straws, coffee stirrers, and cotton swabs. Africa. Africa is also taking a firm stance, and many countries on the continent have already banned single-use bags. In Rwanda, for example, it is illegal for anyone, even tourists, to bring one into the country.
People travel and through airlines, people come get to the airport, and those who are carrying bags, they leave them there and they are given alternatives.
However, it is only when they walk around Kigali and go to any supermarket that they realize that the ban is real and that it is becoming one of Rwanda's biggest environmental successes.
Rwanda has almost become a theater for visits from different countries to be able to understand how we have been effective in translating the policy into practice with respect to plastic bags ban. And different countries have been amazed at the level of success that Rwanda has demonstrated.
We know very well plastic is a byproduct. It is a new product on the market. We can live without it. But the most important thing is to bring everybody on board.
Others believe that while a ban by individual nations is a good start, much stronger action is required. Sadhguru, an internationally renowned spiritual teacher and founder of the Isha Foundation, calls for global action, both by individual citizens and governments.
I'm talking about one simple solution. This is not a total solution. This is a simple correction step. That is, single-use plastic must be banned in all the countries. Pitch for banning single-use plastic, which is in the form of these kind of covers, and various other small things like straws, coffee cup caps, variety of things that we are using. Wherever you see it, if you refuse to use it, that must become your personal policy. But above all, we want the law to take this up, the policy in the nation to take it up, that single-use plastic must be banned. This will not solve all our problems, but definitely this is one responsible act we can do. Plastic is a great material, but right now it's against us simply because of irresponsible usage. This is our planet, this is our time on this planet. Let's do the right things. Let future generations look at us as a responsible generation of people.
We'll take a moment now to thank the Divine for our magnificent Mother Earth and for all those who work diligently to protect her. Please stay tuned to Supreme Master Television. Welcome back as we continue exploring solutions to plastic pollution in our rivers and oceans. One of the main problems with plastic is that once it is in our waterways, it takes thousands of years to decompose. However, researchers around the globe have been studying ways to accelerate this process. An international team of scientists, headed by Professor John McGeehan, at the Institute of Biomedical and Biomolecular Science, Portsmouth University, UK, has discovered an enzyme that can break plastic down into its original components. When the team altered the structure of this enzyme, the decomposition process became 20% faster, starting within 2 days. With further research, the scientists hope to increase the enzyme's efficiency even more. Currently, plastic is made primarily from petroleum, but scientists around the world are searching diligently for alternative, more eco-friendly materials from which to make it. For example, polyhydroxyalkanoate, or PHA, is a biodegradable material derived from plant-based sources. Mr. Dane Anderson and his twin brother, Mr. Jeff Anderson, have co-founded Full Cycle Bioplastics, a company that produces plastic from this more sustainable alternative.
Full Cycle Bioplastics is the company that we founded that has a technology that can turn any organic waste into a compostable and marine degradable bioplastic. PHA is the new paradigm here. So PHA is both extremely compostable and it's also marine degradable, meaning if it ever falls into the ocean, it actually acts as fish food or bacteria food and has no toxic effects.
Other companies are producing PHA plastics, but they are still too expensive to be sold on the open market. Full Cycle Bioplastics has one significant advantage.
The thing is, everyone else who makes it commercially makes it out of really expensive feedstocks like pure sugars or seed oils. What we do differently is we use organic waste as our feedstock, which is negative cost and it's available everywhere. This stuff can be used for all sorts of things. So whether it's durables, bags, to-go containers, cutlery, water bottles, shampoo bottles, you know, all sorts of things.
In Chile, an award-winning company called Solubag, whose founders are Shining World Invention Award recipients, produces another type of eco-friendly, non-plastic bag. The biodegradable Solubag material was created in 2014 from a new raw material made through a synthesis of calcium carbide and natural gas. The company's environmentally friendly bags completely dissolve in water within 5 minutes and are being used in major shopping centers in Chile.
Nuestro material no es plástico, no tenemos ninguna trazabilidad de plástico dentro del proceso. Somos un material que simulamos ser plástico y eso nos ha llevado a ser un reemplazo muy fácil de ocupar. Todos los productos cuando aparecen son tecnologías totalmente distintas, con maquinaria diferente. Nosotros ocupamos las mismas máquinas que existen, solamente modificamos la materia prima.
Water and drink bottles are also critical sources of pollution. According to Euromonitor, more than 1 million drink bottles are sold every minute of the day. Unfortunately, however, only 14% are recycled and the rest are discarded as trash and often end up being washed into rivers and oceans. Supreme Master Qinghai frequently reminds us about the detrimental impact of plastic pollution on our environment, saying that each of us has a personal responsibility to reduce our use, especially of plastic water and drink bottles.
Plastic bottles have been the cause of suffering for much of marine life because they will float everywhere in the river, in the lake, and then they flow also to the ocean everywhere, and they are not digested with time even. And sometimes fish or other marine life, they swallow them and they cause them a lot of pain and sickness. And sometimes birds also get caught in them or eat them and they get sick also. Please take care of the environment so that we can live in a beautiful place. Not just for the animals, it's also for us. The way we act, we speak loudly of who we are. So show your best character by action.
We are deeply grateful to Supreme Master Qinghai for her tireless guidance and wise words. Through our individual and collective actions, may we quickly resolve the issue of plastic pollution and return our earthly home to a pristine state. Warm-hearted viewers, thank you for your company today. May your inner nobility and divine wisdom grow with each passing day through heaven's grace.
Our programs offer many languages. Please visit suprememastertv.com/schedule and suprememastertv.com/PE.